The following program is brought to you with limited commercial interruption.
Today's broadcast is being simulcast in broken English.
Welcome to the show that we're doing right now.
What the hell are we doing on this show?
Boy, that escalated quickly. I mean, that really got out of hand fast.
It jumped up a notch.
It did, didn't it?
Let's go.
What is this?
Giggity, 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 goo.
Who else but
the Q?
It's showtime. Gentlemen, let's get down to business.
Can you dig it?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to The Q, your list of the best pop culture, current events, current affairs show, east or west of that Mississippi River, hailing from the great city of St. Louis and worldwide at theqnow.com. I am your host, Mark Bland. Joined today, well, let's not even say joined today, documents so secret the FBI had to get clearance for the investigation. Trump in serious hot water over there. So even Fox News is turning on him. We'll talk about that. Oh, AI is starting to really get out of control. We will discuss something from this past week that caught me off guard. I'm sure it's going to catch you guys off guard, too. But, ladies and gentlemen, we also have JSO. That's Jeff O'Connor. He's going to be joining us from MMWA Wrestling to be our guest. Talk some wrestling, and we're going to get his opinion on the world. But without any further ado, there's another person here who is here to talk to us. He is one of my co-hosts, one of my favorite people to join us on the show every single week, Jason Kull. What's going on, Jay?
Hey, how are you? Favorite people, huh? That's pretty cool.
You are you're blasting it here at 12:08 a.m. KYRO. That's right, the blowtorch of the Midwest, sir. Thank you. Welcome to the studios. You've never been to the studios.
First time in this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, for a lot of people out there that we're going to pull the curtain back a little bit, like that pro wrestling we'll talk about with Jeff here in a second. Well, the thing is that sometimes, you know, behind the scenes, the way that radio shows get done is a little different than other things. And sometimes you're not at the studio. You don't have to be at the studio. We weren't at the studio for a while. We didn't need to be. And Jason has never been to the KYRO studios. So welcome to the KYRO studios.
Thank you for welcoming me.
Is it blowing your mind? Is this what you envisioned? Is it sexy? Tell me what your feelings are right
now. It is
now.
Sexy. You know what? I enjoy the waiting room.
The waiting room?
The green room, I guess.
The green room, the front
there.
Area, the lobby area.
It's very relaxed.
It is very relaxed. A lot of guitars.
It has that studio vibe.
Well, that's because we have the Viper, the other radio station that's right next door, our sister station.
And so,
they do a lot of rock and roll stuff.
Yeah. It's a rock and roll look out there.
That's what it is. It's supposed to be a rock and roll look, Jason.
Looks like it.
Well, that's good.
They did a good job.
I'm glad they did. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Let's bring on to the show our friend, a professional wrestler with the MMWA, as well as other organizations, but he comes courtesy of the MMWA tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome JSO.
Oh, my. Hello. How are we doing tonight? I'm glad to be here. I like to talk shit about Trump.
You're glad to be here? Well, first things first, you can't cuss on the radio, sir.
Why not?
Because this is a radio station.
We have the FCC.
And unlike Donald Trump, we're not going to lie to the radio station about things that are going on in our lives. We're just going to be really honest with them when they come and ask for the audio tape. Do you see what I'm saying?
But I didn't do that. It wasn't me.
It was not you.
No, it was the other guy.
Did you just have it thrown on the ground in front of you or something? Is that what happened?
I'm not even sure what you're talking about. Fake news.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Fake news. That makes it all better.
Right. Correct.
I get it. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Well, that is Jeff O'Connor. Welcome.
But hold on a second. I have to also tell you the other names that I'm usually called.
Oh, wait. So there's Jeff. Well, that's your name.
But you
have JSO.
Yes, JSO, of course.
But there is a multitude underneath of this.
Oh, yes, of course.
There are layers to this, Jason.
Some people.
He said, all right.
Call me the Avatar of Excellence.
You could sit next to him over there if you
want. I don't want him close to me.
Oh,
no.
He looks really weird, and I don't like him.
I want to look at him from afar.
I don't like him at all.
I don't know what's going on here. I feel like that it's going to get contentious in here. There could be a wrestling match that breaks out between JSO
and Jason
at this point, and I'm not sure why. Or what happened? Okay, so anyway.
He's looking funny. I don't know.
All right, let's don't worry about Jason.
I'm going to sit down again, okay?
Okay, all right,
thank
sit
you.
Down.
Thank
sit
you.
Down. Just take a seat. Relax.
You're welcome, yes.
Okay, thank you. All right, now.
Yes.
JSO.
Yes.
You have multiple names.
Yes.
Let's get back to the multiple names that you have.
Most people will refer to me as the avatar of excellence because, let's be honest, I'm fantastic. I'm excellent.
I'm not going to lie. I do like the avatar of excellence.
I do
feel like that flows well.
It's fantastic, right?
I like the way it comes off is what I'm trying to
say. Well, thank you. It's just the truth, though.
What else do you have? You have the avatar of excellence. What else do we got?
And as we were talking about MMWA down on South Broadway, the South Broadway Savior is a new moniker that I've taken up because I'm trying to save that place from the crappy other wrestling that happens and the other idiots that are down there.
Okay, so there is a need to save South Broadway.
Absolutely.
From other individuals.
Correct.
That are currently inside of your house, is what you're saying.
Trust me on that.
They are in your house, not fake news.
No, not fake news.
They're
in my ring.
You already invoked fake news once.
Not me. It was just that whatever's going on outside.
It was because of Jason. It was whatever
that
was
other
going
guy
on with
there.
Jason.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, everything that's going on with Jay. Why do you do things, Jay?
He's a moron.
I guess I have to.
Why do you exist?
That's what I do.
You exist?
Exist. To
you barely exist, or you just do exist?
To cause Jeff
consternation.
Oh my God.
Like that's it. You're even using big words.
Where did we find this guy?
Consternation. I don't know, Jeff. I don't know. All right. So, Avatar of Excellence, the South Broadway Savior.
Yes.
I like all of these. Anything else?
Yes.
Is there anything else?
We'll stick with those two because I'm not sure how intelligent your audience is or anything like that.
This
guy sitting next to me.
First off, this is not a conservative radio station show.
Thank the Lord.
It's a conservative radio station. It's not a conservative radio station show here on Fox News Radio. Like, we are a moderate liberal show. Like, we are educated.
Yes.
We paid for our loans by our own hands.
We got our
degrees with our own hands.
Great.
We are, and if other people are getting student loan debt forgiveness, we're not angry about it.
No, I'm not mad.
We're not mad at other people.
That's great to hear.
Like, we're not those
people.
That's
ridiculous. That you'd be mad. Why would you be mad?
But see,
stupid.
And that's a great question, Jeff. I don't understand why there are so many. Like, for this has been what I would, other than the news that broke in the last couple of days, this week has been what I would consider a relatively boring news cycle. Like, compared to the last seven straight years I've been dealing with, like, this last week has been kind of boring. Everybody's still on the student loan forgiveness. If you're conservative, all you do is talk about it constantly. Like, you, yeah. And by the way, I've got some new ways, points of view to like, Jeff, actually, I'm glad you're here. Let's get to this right off the bat, Jay.
Let's go.
Let's get on
JSO,
this.
Please. Stop calling me Jeff.
Well, okay, JSO.
Yeah,
I'm very, very sorry.
Yeah, don't happen again.
Well, I just figured JSO was like initials or something.
It is, but that is who I am.
You are JSO.
That's who you're talking to.
Yes, sir. We'll not make that mistake again, I promise.
Thank you.
I apologize. So some points of view, some ways to look at this entire student debt forgiveness, loan forgiveness, however you want to talk about it. Some points of view. Okay, so conservatives, and these are all ways, Jason, for conservatives, Jeff. I mean, JSO and our friend Jay. These are always conservatives could look at this properly in context for themselves and maybe make it feel like it's okay. Like, it's all right to be a person who is getting student loan forgiveness, and this is the easiest way to do this. So, for many years, conservatives, and Jason, back me up on this, because you are quite the astute researcher like myself.
That's right.
For many years, conservatives complained about big government, right?
Oh, yeah.
And taxes are out of control, right? Taxes are out of control.
Spending,
we need less taxes. We need less taxes. And by the way, there have been other Democratic presidents well before Joe Biden, correct?
There have been.
Okay. And those presidents have passed laws and of situations and whatever, however you want to look at it, so that there were things that were taxed. There were times where there was no taxes were lowered. Like, these other presidents have done this. And at those times, conservatives were very angry, very unhappy at the time, because whoever it was that was benefiting wasn't them. They weren't getting this. Their taxes were getting raised, so they weren't getting any of this money. It was more money coming out of their pockets, and it was out of control, right?
Mm-hmm.
So my new perspective that I want them to try, JSO, is simply looking at this situation as an overall.
Okay.
And then going, oh, this is just money owed back to me for things that I was unhappy about in the past at different times. Like, think about it that way, ladies and gentlemen. Very simple to change your perspective and just look at the fact that you're a conservative.
Jason, have you already paid back all your student loans?
No, not all. I will probably get at least $10,000 of that.
You will probably get some money out of that.
I will.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough. It could be you, your wife, whoever, the student loans. I'm not sure. I've already paid back all my student loans. But for you, Jason, and those conservatives out there that might get $10,000 back.
Yeah,
or if they did the Pell
actually.
Grant thing, the $20,000, right?
Yeah.
It could be up to $20,000 if you got a Pell Grant situation. You guys are just getting something to enjoy and use for yourself.
Yeah.
Like, this is a little money back. Don't take it personally. Pay those debts off. I think the way they're going to handle it's probably direct to everybody's student loans, probably through Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac type stuff.
Yeah,
they'll just take it right off. Yeah, they'll literally just take it right off the top. Right. So nobody's going to be getting a check in the mail to like pay anything off. So, you know, just enjoy the fact that you got $10,000 less that you have to pay towards your student loan. And listen, if you're one of those people that was at 12.5, now you only got $2,000 to pay off.
Just a little bit more.
The end of the year.
Just a little bit more.
Just a little bit.
So what do you think about that, JSO? Do you think it's a good way to look at it?
No, I think you hit the nail on the head there. It's not coming from the taxes. They're not taking it from taxes or making your taxes higher. They're literally forgiving these bonds, these loans that technically the government owns already because they've purchased them back from these companies you just mentioned.
That's right.
So they're not even taking, they're just saying, oh, it's gone. Poof.
Yeah, magic.
Just
it's
right out
gone.
Right out the air.
And I don't see any conservatives, no matter how much they complain on Facebook or that other junk app that they get on, they're not saying, oh, we're not going to take it. They're just mad other people are getting it too. They're taking
that's it.
That's it.
They're just mad other people are getting it. And that's why I'm saying, for all of you conservatives out there that are getting this, but you want to get on your Facebook feed every day because... Let's be honest. Let's out you for who you are, okay? We all know that nobody has access to your personal private information, like how much you owe on a student loan, whether you're Jason, a conservative, JSO, myself, doesn't matter who it is. We know that you literally have the only access to your account. No one else is going to know if you're lying or telling the truth, if you're one of these people that just gets on your Facebook like you will. If you're a conservative, you will get on your Facebook. You will complain ostensibly about this situation, like as deep as you can possibly complain about it.
You will share.
You know, what's weird, though, is none of them complained when Trump dropped the corporate tax by like 15%. None of them got super mad that their taxes didn't go down 15%. They didn't even bat an eye.
Right. It doesn't matter if corporate taxes go down 15% because it's not my taxes.
They didn't get mad. They didn't go, oh, I'm not paying for that corporate tax.
Right.
None of them said that.
No. So that's my point, ladies and gentlemen. I think it's just a perspective switch. That's all we need for everybody. It doesn't need to be anything more or less than that. Just a bit of a perspective switch, and boom, you're right back into where you need to be. Now, JSO, since we're gonna get to know you a little bit better here in a second, but after the break. But before we get to it, one thing I would like to know.
Yes.
Since you're coming on to a show that tends to be political, and its stylings, not necessarily geared for politics all the time, because we're going to talk about other things today. But if people were to like try to ask you, where is your stance on politics? Are you for? Are you against? Abstaining? You have nothing to say? You're a Trump guy? You're not a Trump guy? You're a Biden guy? You're not a Biden guy? Like, where do you stand?
I have been the last few years extremely active on all of my social media with that. I'm very moderate. I see the left point of view. I see the right point of view.
Sure.
I do not see the Trump point of view, because that is not just the right point of view. That's the far, far, far off the deep end, right? And then I don't
Which
see
is
a lot.
Weird, though, because we have a lot of people in St. Louis and around this area in the rurals that are just Trump voters. Like, it's not even about looking at the overall and trying to figure out if you want to be a moderate or just a regular staunch Republican. It's literally just this idea of that guy won. He was a president. I'm in. Like,
I think I voted the last time. I was very upset because I went to vote on my ballot and most of these judges were Republicans. They didn't have anybody against them. There was no Democratic option. It was just them. They got voted in. All these people, there was no one side or the other. It was literally just the Republican option. So I didn't vote at all for them because I didn't like that idea.
And that's a problem that we've had in St. Louis specifically for a long, long time.
Yeah, lots of
Missouri as a state overall has this issue. It doesn't, like, if you go down to Phelps County or some of these other smaller counties in the middle of nowhere, Like, what you just described is the entire ballot. Like, it's just all red, all one-sided. And only if there was some disagreement at the local bar last Friday, those two might be going up against each other for the election the next week.
Ridiculous.
Like, beyond that.
Ralph's going after Bob.
Exactly. So it's crazy to me. Like, I don't understand how any of that works or why these people seem to have this mentality about them. But we are going to take a quick break here on The Q. You are listening to 105.3 FM, 1280 AM KYRO, News Radio, KYRO.com, Fox News Radio specifically. And you're listening to The Q with Mark Bland, our special guest JSO, as well as Jason Kull. We'll be back on The Q after this. KYRO. Welcome back to The Q on this beautiful Saturday. Every single Saturday, 1 to 3 p.m. Central Standard Time on The Q. Mark Bland, our guest, JSO. What's going on, man?
That's me.
That is you. And Jason Kull, of course, over there.
Of course.
Hanging out with us. Just, you know, just handling a little bit of that business. You know what I'm saying? We know how you guys handle it. We love how you handle that business. Okay, JSO, before we went to the break, we were talking to you for a few seconds there. We were asking you a little bit about your background.
Yes.
Talking about the fact that we were going to get into your background a little bit. So I love to interview people. I love to get to the nitty-gritty of things. So let's break you down here real quick. Where are you from? What part? Are you from St. Louis, Missouri? No? Yes?
I am. Born and raised right in St. Peter's, Missouri.
So you're from St. Peter's?
I am, yes.
All right. Just down the road. And with that being said... You grew up in the rurals. We discussed that you're more of a moderate like myself and a centrist like me and Jason. Well, actually, I would say that Jason's a little more left than I am, honestly.
I'm probably a little more left.
Are you still an Iron Maiden fan?
I'm totally an Iron Maiden fan.
Okay, so he's definitely to the left.
Mark doesn't like Iron Maiden.
He's definitely hardcore to the left is what he is. A hardcore leftist.
In fact, I listened to Iron Maiden today.
I'm sorry that you did that. I don't know why you would hurt your ears with stuff like that. But hey, that's up to you, bud.
Live after death.
I'm not going to hold it against you. I don't mind.
I'm going to hold it against him, though. That's, you know,
that's kind of weird. It is a little weird.
It's another thing that it's on the list now.
It's always
another thing on the list.
Another thing on the list. Okay, so JSO.
Yes.
You're from St. Peter's.
Yes.
You're born and raised out here. Growing up, sports?
Yes.
Were you into sports?
Yes.
What were you into?
So I actually played AAA hockey for the Amateur Blues.
You did?
I did, yes. Nice. I was a goalie.
So you were a goalie.
Yes.
So did you get to hang out with Grant Fear at times in your life? Or,
no.
Jordan Binnington at all ever? Or
Binnington was a little after my time.
06?
Mike McKenna was there around there. So was Ben Bishop. Was a little bit younger than I was.
Oh, I'm sorry. 2016.
Ben Bishop's like 9 foot tall.
Yeah, he's
a huge
horrendously
dude.
Tall. Right. I played with Cam Jansen, Joey Vitale.
We know Cam. Mm-hmm. We know Cam very well. Cam's a radio broadcaster like ourselves now on a different station, and we're friends with Cam.
Yep.
So
Cam played with him. Yeah, he was our scorer back then. So
yeah, sure. So what years are we talking about here when you're doing the Junior Blues stuff?
Oh, gosh. What was that, 98, 99?
So you're talking about late 90s into the early 2000s.
Yep.
Okay, that's fair. So what's Junior Blues go up to, 18?
Yes.
Okay, so do you make it to 18?
I did, yes.
And then what after that? Like, you're not a Junior Blue anymore, so what's our next step? Like, what's going on there, and what year are we talking about now?
We are talking, 02, 03, right around there.
Okay.
I had a couple options. I had a scholarship to West Point, and then also...
Wait,
They have a hockey team?
They do.
J-S-O.
Yes.
Burying the frickin' lead. Okay, we need to talk about this. Did you just say the words West and Point together at the same time?
Yes.
As in the military college?
Yes, that would be the one.
And
Army,
yes, it is the Army. Now, you were supposed to go to West Point?
I had the option to play hockey for them.
So they looked at you as an option for their team?
Correct, yes.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And also for
AKA
Tulsa.
Being drafted almost. Like
almost.
What is that they call it in college? It's not drafted. You get...
Signed?
Well, no, no. You, of course, you get signed in either case, but no, they call
they wanted me there. Yeah.
I'm just saying, like, it's not drafted, but they
recruited.
Yeah. There it is, recruitment. Yeah. So you got recruited by West Point. Now, to get into West Point in the first place, ladies and gentlemen, for anybody out there who might not know about West Point too much, which JSO probably knows a lot about it.
A little bit.
You got to be smart.
Yes.
It's an education thing with West Point. Yeah, like, it's not morons that are going there.
It's not military.
We're talking about a St. Louis junior blue who's getting straight A's, obviously, who's able to go to a place like a West Point. So we're talking about an educated individual. So you had West Point. What else?
I had the option to play junior hockey at Tulsa as well. However, I declined both of them.
The Golden Waves? Is that it? Is that the Tulsa Golden Waves? Is that it?
I'm not sure what they are.
Something like that.
Something ridiculous.
Or is it the Green Waves? It could be the Green Wave. The Tulsa Green Wave or something like that?
One of those Louisiana schools is like a Green Wave or something.
Oh, I'm sure
that sounds terrible.
Yeah,
it doesn't sound terrible. Louisiana. Ugh. Or some Missouri.
It just hearing the idea of like, hey, I'm going to go play hockey in Tampa. And people would be like, Tampa.
Tampa sounds fun, though.
And then all of a sudden, they're winning like 90 championships back to back in the middle of like the hottest days of the year and stuff.
Bishop
like, it's ridiculous. All right. Yeah. So you've Tulsa, West Point.
Yep.
Anything else?
No, but I declined.
Was there any professional options on the board? I mean, you were
not
a junior blue. You
not
were a junior blue. I'm thinking that the organization is obviously paying attention to their junior blues.
Correct.
If something's going to pop up, it might pop up out of there. Now, you're a goalie.
Correct.
It's a little bit. Yours really comes down to simply, if the puck gets in too much and someone else lets it in less, they're just going to get the starting job.
Yes.
You might physically be point for point in the ability to be a better goalie than that guy, but for whatever the situations on the ice present, he just happens to let less in, so you don't get the starting shot, which is a little different than the other positions in the sport, because those are more literally designed on, well, he didn't score 19 goals, he only had 14, but he's a hell of a defender. He's got like 20 steals, he's got like this or that, you know, 30 assists, whatever. Like, it's just ridiculous things.
And there's way more of those guys.
Yeah, there's a lot more of those guys, so there's a lot more competition there. So
the performance is a lot more analyzed, of course, with the goalie, because like you said, the puck's going by is what they look at.
That's it. That's literally all it comes down to. And yeah, they'll pay attention to the little things that they go, well, because he does this a little bit differently, he might have a better chance of stopping things in this area. But what it really comes down to is the puck crossing that line. End of story. So all of that's on the table, but nothing from the junior blues. Where do you do?
I declined everything and decided to to go learn to be a professional wrestler.
Wait.
It's a better move.
Hard turn there. Hard turn.
It's a better move.
Professional wrestler. So can I tell you a fun story?
Please.
This is a fun little story. There was a famous Blues alumni that decided after his career was finitoed, he wanted to try to be a pro wrestler. So he came down to South Broadway's Annex building for a couple of weeks in a row.
Okay.
He lasted two training sessions.
Who is this?
One on this. I will not.
I need to know.
Now, listen, I will say this. I have probably said this name before on one of the cues. I'm not 100% sure. There have been over 500 episodes at an hour and a half to 2 hours, and some are 3 hours long. So that's a lot of audio to listen back through. If you want to look for it, I'm sure you could find me telling this story at a prior time in the years past, and then maybe the name pops in there.
Okay.
But as far as right now goes in this situation, I just keep everyone off of the table. But I will say this.
Okay.
He came in. He wanted to be a pro wrestler. This is a guy who was destined for the Hall of Fame, in my opinion. Potentially, as far as St. Louisans go and how much they love this person, I know that they love him in their eyes. Mm. So I will say this. He came in, he tried out, he went through the training, but I guess he just beat him up a little bit too much taking the bumps, because by show two, or not show two, but training session two, he was out.
You think he'd be able to handle
it? He was done. Now he had cardio.
Yeah.
And he definitely was a tough person who had the ability to handle, he's a hockey player,
he's taking
a lot of hits and stuff. So I know he's a tough dude that regard. So there you go.
It's different. It's a different ballgame.
It is a different girl. So you get into pro wrestling.
Yes.
And I bet as a young man trying to get into the sport for the first time, because it's 19. When I get into the sport, and I'm not here to talk about me, but when I get into the sport in 97, it's a much different world.
Yes.
Right? High-speed internet doesn't exist. First off, for all of you Dave Meltzer fans out there, I will name certain people by name. For all of you Dave Meltzer fans, I understand Bret Hart has gone on the record and said that he called Dave Meltzer directly after the Montreal Screwjob. Okay, so Dave, at the time that we're talking about the Montreal Screwjob, that's 97.
Okay,
yeah, okay.
Yeah.
So Dave is in the lexicon of the business at that time, but he is a very small computer vlogger dude putting out a news zine letter that he had to print off of a fax machine up out of the Northeast at that time. He is not somebody that's got millions of followers that anyone listens to, that anyone gets their news from. And I'm not dogging on Dave. I'm literally telling you the truth. He was small and he was up in the Northeast. He wasn't nationwide yet and he wasn't down here.
Okay.
So, it's just a different time period. By the time 2002 rolls around and you get into the business, right, the internet does have high-speed internet. Now, we're not quite to the YouTube days yet, but we do have websites that are developing.
Yes.
There are internet websites that are dirt sheets that are becoming popular for a lot of people. And I would assume that, you know, you're paying attention to these things.
Oh, yeah.
As you're trying to get into the business. So for me, I was told by a lot of it was offline. It was all behind the scenes. It was the true kayfabe days in 97. So they're telling me, don't go online. Don't talk to anyone about this. And at that time, it wasn't even don't go online. It was just don't talk to anyone about this. Keep this to yourself. We don't talk about our business outside of these doors to anybody. Nobody's supposed to know this, that, and the other. And I was totally down. Like, I was like you, a young guy trying to get into business. It was like, yeah, whatever you guys say. Okay.
Absolutely.
Also, those were the guys that would go to the bar after the shows in whatever city. And then if a guy wanted to fight him at the bar,
they'd fight.
They would fight those people at a bar. This was not the, oh, I've got to go check up on my Dragon Ball Z characters and then I'm going to go to sleep really early because Tony Khan says I got to get to the studio by 10 a.m. tomorrow. Can you believe it? So early. those people.
They're living it 24/7.
Yeah, they did. Most of those guys did.
All right. Fair enough. Mm-hmm. No, there's some really good workers out there nowadays. I'm not going to knock every single person. There's bad workers and good workers at all time periods in the history of the business. So anyway, you start taking bumps.
Yes.
Hockey player.
Yes.
How's it feeling?
So GCW was where I went to do the training. Of course, at the time was the mecca of the St. Louis area.
It was still Broadway at that time because Broadway was on the cover of the Riverfront Time and the Post-Dispatch. Okay. Like GCW, once again, there were people in St. Louis. This isn't a knock on GCW anyway, by the way, because I was literally a wrestler who was in competition with GCW period that we're talking about.
Okay.
I knew Ben. I knew Jim. I knew all these people, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Not bad people.
No.
They had good workers over there. Hey,
yes.
A buddy of mine named John ended up going over there. He becomes Dingo. Great worker.
Dingo.
Like, these are good workers, the solid guys. I've known a lot of them over the years. So I have nothing bad to say about GCW. I don't think it was the mecca.
For me, it was.
For you, it was, because they were a little bit more of an edgier product.
Sure. And they had a lot of the guys that, you know, I had known had gone over there and trained as well.
Okay.
Seidel.
So you knew these people personally?
Yes, prior to actually going to GCW.
You're talking about Matt Seidel?
Yes, of course.
Now, how did you know Matt? Like, I knew Matt trained at GCW, so he was a trainee there at the time, and he was probably a little bit beyond a trainee at that time.
Oh, yeah,
But my question is, how did you know Matt prior to this?
So during the hockey days, we actually all did backyard wrestling here in St. Louis, and there was about three or four.
I remember old LWA shows in the middle of DeSoto that my buddy... God, I always forget his dang... He's got a French name. Pierre. Mm-hmm. Pierre. Yes, yes.
Do you remember what was before LWA? In the barn?
Man, that's Richard. That's Sam days. I got to call Sam or Big Sexy up to find out that information right there.
So that was when we're talking about. So I wrestled in that barn, WCWF.
I thought it was LWA at the barn, too, though.
They may have at the very end.
Okay, that's
WCWF possible. Was what they called themselves at first.
Okay.
We were EWA out in St. Peter's. There was
I did not
Matt
know
stuff.
There was an EWA in St. Peter's at all.
SPWO, like, there's all kinds of stuff.
Wow, this is, so you come from the backyard.
Oh, yeah,
group.
That's where everybody started back then, pretty much there.
Well, that's
that
fair.
Whole group.
That's fair. But at that time period, if you were a backyard wrestler, that was looked down upon.
Terrible,
at that time
yes.
period.
Oh, yes.
Nowadays, everybody looks back and goes, man, Jeff, they're Hall of Famers. Like, now, though, but back then.
But they did it the right way. They went and got trained.
Sure, and then, so did that's, you. Yeah, that's what happened with you guys. You started here, but eventually it turned into GCW, and you guys are over there. Correct. So do you debut at GCW?
I had various different matches, under hoods, getting my butt kicked, you know, in different various ways with that on there. I was really a lot smaller than I am now, so the bumps took a big toll on me.
Okay.
And I did end up hurting my neck pretty bad there pretty early on with them.
Okay, fair enough. So the neck, though, it's obviously healed since.
Yeah.
I famously left the industry because I cracked a vertebrae in my neck, and so that's why I kind of had to leave in the first place, because my wife said, it's either me or a wheelchair, and you better choose wisely. So I was like, the wheelchair doesn't take me anywhere, so
Wait,
but then again, it kind of does. I never thought about that at the time.
You could.
Maybe I should have just put her on my lap in the wheelchair, and then
that's... Professor X gets around in a wheelchair.
That's true. It's Professor fun. S does do that. Are you a comic book guy?
Oh, big comic book guy. Yes, of course.
Oh, so when I'm making fun of the nerdy comic book people with their Dragon Ball Z, is that you, or are you a comic book guy?
That's anime. Yeah. I do like it, but you know,
it's a different world.
Yeah,
a little
it really
bit.
Is. Yeah.
Well, yeah, because think about it. You know a lot of wrestlers nowadays.
Yeah.
You've been in the locker rooms with them. You see them reading the comic books and doing their thing. Some of them even try to dress like they're getting like influenced by like the type of clothing that the anime characters are wearing.
Yes,
whether
absolutely.
It's One Piece or this or that or whoever it is. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, that's interesting, JSO. So you debut at GCW?
Yep, did a couple matches with them, yep.
And then where do you go?
Oh, gosh, all around Illinois, the little various places around there.
No Missouri work?
No, at the time I did not. My neck wasn't good. I was about 170 pounds.
Did you go by JSO at that time?
I did not, no. Mm-mm.
Okay.
No. Went by, I don't even remember what I went by. There were several different names. There was a mask gimmick with that has actually the little shirt I'm wearing here now is Ghostface. So we actually did some weird gimmick with that too.
Okay.
It was fun. We had a lot of fun, but it really didn't last much longer just because of, like I said, I was hurting pretty bad. And, you know, when you get hurt, you just kind of lose interest a little bit and try to realize what's going on.
Here's what we're going
to
do. Put a little pin in that right there. We're going to take a quick break here on KYRO. JSO is our guest. Me, Jason Kull. We'll be back on the show right after this. That's Iron Maiden right here on 1280 MKYRO. This is the Rock of St. Louis. Iron Maiden, boys and girls. Oh, they're going to be over at the Riverport soon, so you better get out there to that show. Welcome back to the queue. It's Mark Bland over here, rocking the midday with you here at the Blowtorch here on the Iron Maiden plane. JSO is here going on, and I got Jason Kull. Oh, the Kullster over there. Hold on. You know, stupid, like, morning show, side afternoon. Like, I always, listen, I love broadcasting because just like pro wrestling, and just like we were talking about with JSO in pro wrestling, there is so many characters, different voices and sounds, and people that are talented. A guy like a Phil Hendry with the ability to go back and forth with one single button and be a phone caller for himself, as well as different voices interacting with himself to turn around and make that a career. You know what I'm saying? Other guys talking about UFOs and he's like, I'm Art Bell now. Like, deal with it. Like, I love that aspect. But ladies and gentlemen, we have JSO here on the queue today. Welcome back to the show, JSO. I'm sorry.
Turn my mic on, please.
I'm sorry.
Let's go.
I turned your mic on. Ugh. I'm so sorry. My goodness.
He's looking at me, staring at me, and I'm like, I'm talking, and you just haven't turned it on yet.
This is so weird. You're like such this brute. Like, see, I don't understand. Were you ever like a nighttime show host? Was that ever your gimmick?
No, but I've done it before a little bit with some people that I've known.
Okay.
A little bit, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where was that at?
Down off Hampton somewhere. I don't know.
Okay.
Some small little ridiculous studio.
Okay.
They had to drive way too far for.
Did you have to drive way too far for?
It's ridiculous.
Okay. So you spend some time with GCW.
Yes.
You start moving around, going around the different places. Do you ever land anywhere permanent for before now? I'm talking about before now. Do you land somewhere permanent where we got some stories, or have you always just kind of been floating?
Honestly, no. With, like I said, being so light at the time, and being about 6 foot tall,
people just weren't picking up.
It just I lost interest in it. I discovered alcohol and sex,
okay.
other interests that were much more important than at the time. So
I see.
I did a lot of those. I did a lot of that.
But are we talking about in your early to mid 20s?
Yes.
That's the typical time when these things kind of fall into people's lives. And they are
typical stuff. Yeah.
Either they do it for a little while, like me, you, and JSO over here.
Yes.
And they just grow up out of that, or they become dependent alcoholics. or drug addicts. There is no in between on these two things. Either you will learn your lesson from a couple of weird nights, or you won't learn your lesson at all.
Anything in moderation, right?
Everything in moderation actually is what you learn. You just got to be careful. Like, don't get me wrong, you'll figure out the moderation can be high after you've tried a couple things a few times. You see what I'm saying? But other things, you try them once and you're like, we could have done half of that today. Just today alone, we could have done half of that. Okay, so JSO.
Yes.
You don't land anywhere, but you're with MMWA now.
Correct. Yes.
There is a show coming up.
There is. September
10th. And that is a big match you got coming up.
I do. So
you're with let's do this in order.
Okay.
So you're back with MMWA. You're with MMWA now.
Correct.
I'm sure that you probably worked some shows prior to becoming a part of the roster. But
no, I didn't.
No, just right in.
I walked in and said, listen here, dude, I'm coming in. You're going to put me because I'm awesome. I'm the avatar of excellence.
Wait. Who's the guy? Who's the guy you had to...
Anthony Castaldi.
He's the guy you had to talk to.
I walked in and said, listen, I'm JSO. I'm the avatar of excellence.
Okay.
You're going to put me on this show. And he said, oh, yes, Mr. JSO, I will do that.
He said, oh, yes, Mr. JSO. Now, I knew his uncle Tony very well. Actually, I've wrestled against his uncle Tony.
I've heard great things.
At a time period early in my career, and when he was still young enough to get around.
Wow.
And I will tell you this. I don't know of that family to ever be like, oh, whatever you say, Mr. JSO, I'll just do it for you. I've never known that to be the typical run. Is that what really happened? Is it fake news?
That is what JSO, that is what I remember, and that is what my story. I'm sticking to it.
That's fair.
Because I'm awesome. And that's why I'm the South Broadway Savior.
That's fair. Yeah. So, you walk in, and how long ago was this? How long have you been with MMW?
This was actually my first show with them was the Tony Costa Memorial Battle Royal. That show
was
in May.
Earlier this year?
In May, yes.
So do you feel that MMWA is just another stop on the tour that has been JSO for all these years? Or do you feel that MMWA might be a home for a little while?
You know, I love it down there. I really do. It was always on the list of places to go to visit to that venue to actually have a match.
I mean, it's no GCW, which is the mecca of wrestling.
Well, they're not around anymore, right? So they're gone.
Fair enough.
But no, Broadway was always there, and there's always that attraction that you're going to go down in that club, and you're going to have matches there in front of that crowd, and it's always a hot crowd. I mean, it's always packed.
It is.
Packed. Five, 600 people. I mean, there's places that will get that building that can't even put half that in there. And it's ridiculous. I mean, they're just missing out, and they have huge, huge stars that national people would know who they are, and they can't pack that building like we do on Saturday nights. So,
but I also understand, and so anyway, evidently there's just other organizations that exist, and you don't feel that they do as good a job as far as getting the place packed.
That particular place, they do not.
As MMWA.
They don't. Mm-mm.
And that's fair. That's understandable. That's not a knock on other. See, and I understand there's a lot of organizations. I understand a lot of organizations have a different vibe and a different feel. Certain people like a certain vibe and a feel to their product. I understand why an AEW exists, why it's popular, but I also understand why the Monday Night War started. What about WWE, which... No, I'm going to be honest with everybody out there. And I know that you guys pay attention to the show because you know I was a wrestler and you know a little bit about my background and this and that, but we talk politics. But when I get into some of these discussions, Jay, or JSO, I really I want to get these things off the top of my head. Like, MMWA is a killer place to do anything.
Yes.
It's really a good organization. It's where I started. It's where a lot of other people have started. Mm-hmm. They've always found a way to connect with St. Louis. And for whatever reason it is, from the first day I ever walked into that club, it felt like St. Louis wrestling and boxing. To me, every time I stepped into that club, it was like, this is where the best of St. Louis come to perform. And at that time period, back in the early days of my career, Herb Simmons and Tony Costa were partners.
Yes.
So all those big names you like to see at SICW or other organizations and stuff, which is not a knock on those. We're not knocking these people. Those people were coming down and being on those shows with MMWA / SICW. They were a part of that. So that was the lore of St. Louis Wrestling. Yes. It was an offshoot of the old St. Louis Wrestling Club. I was completely blown away when I did some research.
Okay.
I did some research on the old Sam Munchnick, the old NWA, St. Louis Wrestling Club. I had to clear my throat for this for a reason. JSO, you understand the clearing your throat?
No.
To get people's attention?
No, I just talk really loud.
Okay, that's fair too.
Yeah, sorry.
So I was completely confused.
Yes.
And I'll tell you what I was confused about.
Okay.
The MMWA organization that you currently wrestle for.
Correct.
I was always told, and I was told by some very reputable individuals over my career, people who are not even here with us anymore, that it was an old offshoot of the St. Louis Wrestling Club, which was the original organization that was based in with Sam Munchnick and the NWA. This is where the Kiel Opera House and Wrestling at the Chase and all that kind of comes out of this. And then when he kind of stopped being a part of the NWA or whatever, the St. Louis Wrestling Club like evolved into what became MMWA. They would hold their tournaments and matches at South Broadway Athletic Club, and that's how the relationship developed or whatever. That's what I was always told. Now, is that information 100% accurate? I do not know. But for that information, I went online. I can't find anything about the St. Louis Wrestling Club being connected to MMWA, really? Which is really odd because at one point in my career, a long time ago, when I had a match with a guy by the name of Donovan Ruddick, which was promoted through this show and Absolute Wrestling Radio, which was an incarnation of this show before it existed. Back then, it was on the internet. It was there. You could read about how the St. Louis Wrestling Club turned into MMWA and a couple of other little small offshoot organizations after that, and then moved on with life. But now it's been like wiped from the books.
That's strange.
It is very strange. I don't understand why it was wiped from the books. Maybe you should talk to Mr. Anthony Castaldi.
Yeah.
And like I said, I've known these people for many years. Like, maybe you should talk to them and ask them about this problem. I feel like this is a problem.
I don't see that as a problem right now.
No. It's not like some...
Not for me.
It's not some...
I don't care.
It's not some problem that is like burdening anyone at this point.
You seem really burdened by this right now, though.
No, it kind of blew my mind that at one point, 10 years ago, 12 years ago, it was on the internet. Like, it was there everywhere. Was it
Wikipedia? Like, you can change that.
It was not Wikipedia.
Are you sure?
You're
kind of old.
It could have been, but it wasn't. My point being, now there's nothing.
Okay.
There's just nothing.
Okay, well, that's weird.
Probably a St. Louis wrestling wrestling page on Wikipedia.
Okay.
For the old wrestling club. And I don't even know if it says anything about it or not.
Someone's page probably went down.
But there, you could change that, though, remember?
There's some shady people in every industry, in every city. So if they had the ability to change something, they would likely do that to make themselves look better or worse. To other people.
You could be right.
Donald Trump.
You said that there was a show coming up on September 10th.
Yes.
You guys, according to what I'm reading here, you guys have a match coming up against the tag team champions?
Yes.
Is that correct?
The Dragon's Guild, I think they're called?
The Dragon's Guild.
The Baby Dragons, I call them.
You call them the Baby Dragons.
Stupid Baby Dragons.
Now, who's in the Dragon's Guild?
You have fake Baby Daniel Bryan.
Okay,
the light heavyweight champion, little guy.
Okay.
Then you have an even smaller guy named Chris Exodus, I think is his name. I don't even know his name, really.
An even smaller guy.
He's even smaller. Guy? Yes. Exodus.
Could
he's
you
small.
Imagine if like Steve-O hung out with Wee Man, but then they brought Mini Me along with him, like to hang out?
That's pretty
like
much what
an
it
even
is.
Smaller version of
they're the champion
of Steve or not Steve-O,
yeah.
But Wee Man.
And then there's this other guy. So Exodus and his tag team partner.
Okay,
is
but they're the champions.
Elride.
Okay.
He calls himself a one man zoo. He doesn't wear shoes.
He doesn't wear shoes.
He doesn't wear shoes.
Why doesn't he wear shoes?
He's an idiot. I'm going to step on his foot. That's the first thing I'm doing. Mark my word. You come down and watch this on September 10th. The first thing, the bell's going to ring, I'm going to step on his foot.
That's a good plan.
Now, I have a question.
Step on his foot.
Right.
I get that you are a very... You're the South Broadway Savior.
Of course.
As we have already discussed. The Avatar of Excellence?
Yes. Okay. That as well. Yes, please.
And JSO.
That is just who I am.
You are just the impetulant one.
Yes, if okay. you want to call me that.
And so with that being stated,
we'll add that to the thing.
You're obviously the main event star of this September 10th show, correct?
I will have the best match of the night, yes. Okay. 100%.
I was going to ask, I was just asking because I'm looking at the flyer here.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of women that are on the flyer. There's like multiple women and a mystery opponent coming up.
There is,
and
yes.
they seem to make the flyer about them mm-hmm. and not just a picture of you with your foot stomping on some little smaller guy's foot.
Yeah, yeah. No, it's okay. This is actually the first time, and I don't know the exact amount of years, but there hasn't been a women's champion in a very long time.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. There hasn't been a women's champion at Broadway in years?
Years.
Really?
Yeah, years.
That's crazy. I did not know that.
So they're finally, they've been working really hard. Anthony behind the scenes has been working really hard to try to develop that division, bringing people in from around the country to get this division going because women's wrestling, and I used to not be a fan at all back when I was a teenager.
Sure.
But now it's fantastic, and there's a lot of really great athletes, a lot of really great women that are coming up here.
I'm not going to lie to you. One of my favorite, not even a meme, just a picture, a random picture of the last 20 years alone is a picture of Jade Cargill. Oh, yeah. Walking to the ring in AEW, and somebody holds up a sign that says pee break. Literally holds up a sign that says pee break.
Yep.
And a picture That's is a picture funny. Of her flipping the sign off. And
I've
him
seen
off.
That.
And it's hilarious.
I don't understand that. I wouldn't go anywhere when she walks out. No, I'm just going to watch the TV.
I'm just saying, though, that's hilarious because that's for years, you talked about when you're young
yeah.
and stuff
oh,
like
yeah.
that. For many years in this industry, and as a person who's been a part of this industry since mm-hmm. 97, along with a lot of people that are on TV now who are very well known and yep. they're friends of mine, we've always looked at the women's division has always kind of had a stereotype to it.
Yes.
This was when we need to take a break. This is something not worth watching. It's not something that you want to pay attention to. And you guys are trying to change that.
Oh, absolutely. Yes.
And I
yes.
think that that's amazing that you guys have decided to go head first in on women's mm-hmm. wrestling, give this title a shot again within the annals of history.
Yes.
And you're going to crown a new champion.
Yes.
That
yes,
is
a
the
new
plan.
Champion will be crowned. Yes.
So the same night that you're wrestling mm-hmm. El Ride and the other guy,
ugh,
who's
yeah.
even smaller.
And my tag team partner is.
Can I call him even smaller? Should I just call him even smaller?
That's his new name.
Or something?
I think he calls himself a shoeser weight. I don't know what it means, really.
What does that mean?
It probably means
small shoes.
Small shoes.
I literally cannot yeah. wait until he steps on this guy's foot.
I'm going to step on first thing I'm doing.
You're going to be there just to watch him.
You better be there. I'm going to step on his foot and point at you.
Yes. Yes, that guy.
He told me he was going to do that.
I am. That's what I'm doing. First thing.
That's fantastic. All right.
But no, the women. Sorry, we have to talk about finish this women's sure. segment real quick here.
Yeah,
so
sure.
yeah, it's two different four-way dances. And the winner of those two will wrestle later on in the show for that actual championship.
All right. Well, that sounds like it's going to be
fantastic.
A hell of a show. We've got
yep.
JSO and his partner.
Yep.
Dr. Dallas Stevens. Dr. Dallas Stevens.
He's my ring psychologist.
D.D.S.
Yes.
Got it. Okay. Dr. Dallas Stevens.
Yes.
And you and him are going to be going against El Ride and Chris Exodus.
Something like that, yeah.
The Dragon's Guild.
Babies, yeah.
And then on top of this, we have a main event of a new women's champion being crowned.
Yes.
All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, you need to get down to MMWA Wrestling, South Broadway Athletic Club, September 10th. Check it out. A amazing show being put on by some very talented individuals. We're going to take a quick break here on The Cube. When we come back, more with ourselves, JSO, and Jason Kull. Be back after this. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to The Cue. You are listening to 1280 AM KYRO, News Radio KYRO, this Saturday, every single Saturday, 1 to 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. You can find myself, Jason Kull, a cast of characters, a cavalcade, as we like to say. But today, we are joined by one Mr. JSO. He's hanging out with us. He is definitely not a woman, so he's not in the main event of his show on September 10th for MMWA Wrestling, no. But he is in the show. He has got a championship tag team match him and his partner against the Dragons Guild. So make sure you get down to MMWA Wrestling and check that out. September 10th. You can Google it, search it up, figure it out. They got tickets for sale. We might even put the link up on theqnow.com, theqnow.com, our website for the show. But JSO, beyond the world of wrestling, do you have any hobbies? Are you into anything? There's got to be something that you're into. Sex.
Did you turn my mic on?
Yeah, man, your mic's on. Yeah, no, we can hear you.
I already told you you got into drinking and sex.
No, we didn't turn your mic on. It's gone. Oh, wait, no, now it's back.
Stop it, and you over there, stop talking to me. Yeah.
Gosh darn it. You want to say gosh darn it, don't you?
I stopped myself, didn't I?
All right, so do you have any hobbies? Anything else outside of the world of wrestling that you're into?
Well, you know, other than the comic book stuff and working out.
So you're into comic books.
Yep, working out is a big thing.
Oh, no, yeah. I got rid of working out.
Why would you do that?
Because it takes a lot of time
to
do it properly.
Yes, okay, it does.
You see, did you notice how I said to do it properly? Because there are people that will go spend an hour and a half at a gym, and they will get results, but they're not results.
Correct.
You have to learn how to lift weights for who you are as a person.
Yes.
And then from there, once you get to the point where your muscles are stretching and then they're like healing and then they're stretching on your next workout, you can feel it. Like, you know that you're pushing right. So it's a learned function. So I said that specifically. Oh, but okay. What I wanted to ask is comic books.
Yes.
You're a big comic book guy?
Pretty big, yes.
Pretty big.
Yes.
Favorite comic book character, comic book. Come on, man.
That's a tough question.
Comic
book guys love
Which is
all.
Better, Metallica or Iron Maiden?
Wow, that's.
Do you see how easy these questions really
but
are?
One came before.
It's Metallica.
It's Metallica. It is Metallica.
The answer is Metallica.
Well, it is Metallica.
That's one or the other.
Although Metallica did have a dead spot there in the mid 90s.
Was it a dead spot with Load and Reload? It wasn't really a dead spot. They were just putting out more albums and getting accused of being sellouts.
Yeah, it wasn't selling out.
And as Lars said, selling out concerts and arenas for sure. You're right.
Money, right?
Comic book.
Yes.
Favorite comic book.
Now, of course, the movies have changed everything, but really the Thor comics have been very good, and I love the Guardians of the Galaxy also. They're a favorite of mine.
Now, I just watched the brand new Thor Love and Thunder. I just watched it a couple days ago. Okay?
Good.
Not a bad movie. Solid. I think it does have funny parts.
It does.
I really feel like they should have gotten Ryan Reynolds involved to like help throw in some funny stuff in a couple of other spots. Because we learned from Avengers Endgame, or was it Infinity War? When he comes back as Fat Thor, we learned that he has... we've always known he's had quite the comic styling anyway, working with guys like the... what's his name who does Tony Stark?
Stark is Robert Downey Jr.
Robert Downey Jr.
And you're talking about Chris Hemsworth, right?
Yeah, Chris Hemsworth, working with Robert Downey Jr., working around Deadpool and people, or Ryan Reynolds, people
Ryan
like
Reynolds,
that.
Ryan Reynolds, Deadpool,
These are like entertaining, or Chris, the Star-Lord. Chris Pratt. These are like really good comedic actors. Like they're solid at what they do. So it's good to see him like flex that muscle a little bit because I think it's entertaining. I just wish there would have been a little bit more in the new movie. A little bit more. Not saying there wasn't any. I'm just saying I wish there was a little bit more.
The movie should have been longer. It was cut to an hour, I think just under 2 hours. And most of those movies are like 2.5.
Right.
So I don't know. They missed a bunch of stuff.
Let's talk about that. I don't think that that's actually a bad thing. I'll tell you why. No. That's fine. I'll tell you why, Jeff.
Let's hear it.
The reason is simply the fact that if I'm going into Infinity War or an Endgame, right? This movie where we've taken 13 to 15 other movies. We've like taken pieces out of each of them. We've made another movie over here based off of all that interaction, right? So we have a lot of people, a lot of movies, a lot of characters with important pieces from their movies that we have to connect to each other over here. So I'm going to need a lot of time to do that, to do it effectively. So I feel like you do a 3-hour movie for an Endgame or an Infinity War, that makes sense because I'm connecting like 15 movies, right? But Thor's one movie, it's one character, and this is actually technically kind of a new storyline just for that Thor side of things.
Correct.
So if it goes below 2 hours, that's fine with me. I really don't anymore. I hate to say this because it makes me sound like this old curmudgeon, even though I can sit there and watch, you know, Dances with Wolves or the Shining for 3 hours and 15 minutes with the best of them, okay? But I've become this hour and a half, 90-minute guy. Like, I want my movie in and out in about 90 minutes. Now, I'll give some okay. I'll give some forgiving, saving grace for a Thor, or like a special comic book movie, sure. like a Dark Knight or something like that.
Yeah.
I don't mind it going a little bit longer, depending on what they have to tell me as far as the story goes. But beyond that aspect right there, it really comes down to, hey, I feel like we could tell a lot of these stories in about 90 minutes, like this new piece or this or whatever, maybe an hour and 45 minutes, which is kind of what we're talking about Thor hits on right around that spot right there.
Two and a half minimum.
That you want two and a half.
Two and a half minimum.
Right? Except for if I told you it was going to be a two and a half hour long Brooklyn Nine-Nine. Well, do you see what I'm saying?
I hate
like,
the show.
Like, a long like it's a good show. I like the show, but 2.5 hours right. long. Like, even when they're telling me they're going to do an Entourage movie, I'm like, okay, let's not really bury this too much. Or a Dexter movie, or you
but
know,
you're not paying to go to a theater to watch a spectacle. You're watching it on your television. Right? But
did you think the Batman
sure.
was
Brooklyn Nine-Nine? Yeah, that's why it's designed to be that way.
Well, I just use that as an example.
Well,
I could
have
chosen any movie.
Did you think the Batman was long? Did it feel long?
Okay, so
it was long.
Here's my opinion on the new Batman movie. Now, I might have talked about this a little bit. I might not have. Did you see it?
I did, yes.
And what was your opinion, JSO?
I thought it was very good. You know, that other company, DC, had been putting out some turds here lately, so they did a good job. They did a good job.
I don't know. Justice League wasn't horrible. Like
you've lost all credibility with
it. But I found it. And no.
Yes,
Snyder
watch this. Watch me. No. Watch me bring this back on JSO real quick. You ready for this?
I'm ready.
Most of us never cared about or watched The Flash ever. Like literally ever. Okay, not the TV show ever. So the fact that they found this dude, regardless of his life now, right now in the world,
yeah,
okay, they found this dude, and he came into that movie, and he was the only comic relief in that
good.
Entire Justice League movie, and it made me go, wow, I kind of like The Flash. Like, it made me literally look at Batman and Superman and all these legends I've always watched growing up and go, this guy I didn't know anything about. He kind of comes off the best in the movie. Kind of has a vibe to him. Like it's more of like that Ryan Reynolds Deadpool kind of character or a Thor.
Have you gotten all the way through the 4-hour Snyder Cut?
No, I didn't even watch the Snyder Cut because I don't care.
The beginning of that is
so
confusing.
But I'm not a comic book guy.
That's true. You know what?
That's fine.
He's not at all.
I'm just not a comic book guy. Now, The Boys, I will say The Boys is probably the best TV show on TV. Storylines for even a person who's not a comic book guy at all, super engaging. So if you're able to take comic book stuff and turn it super engaging to me, I'm in. That's why I still watch The Walking Dead to this day. Maybe I lost more credibility with you.
No, I don't know.
The Walking Dead, I feel like the comic books have their vibe. The TV show kind of went and took the story with its vibe. But I like the vibe.
The Walking Dead, is that coming back in October for the final season?
It has to be because I hope.
No.
I think that we got like 6 or 8 episodes left and it's done.
Because there's another one.
I think it's done.
Is it done? Okay.
No.
There's like some other one now.
Oh, no.
There's all kinds of them.
Listen, there's Fear of the Walking Dead. There's an entire channel on Pluto TV that just plays Walking Dead shows.
Oh, boy. No, Walking Dead is good. But you're talking about also, you know, episodes of TV shows versus a movie. That's a totally different thing. I would love to have a Thor show. Give me a 10-hour episode, 1-hour episodes of Thor.
Is Thor your favorite character?
He's one of my favorites, yes.
I mean, Guardians of the Galaxy, I felt that you brought it up because it was something you could tag into.
Yeah, well,
I didn't know if it was actually your favorite
character. No, I do like that version of the movies and that stuff. Yeah, I do.
Okay, that's fair.
You know, when I was a kid, I was a DC guy like a young kid.
I think most people start off DC people literally Batman and Superman are right there.
The older I got, Marvel took over because Marvel's storylines are just better.
Correct.
Marvel's characters are made for movies better. They just do it. Like DC did a good job, but like in the 70s with Superman, I enjoyed that.
Mm-hmm.
Tim Burton's Batman,
great, still great.
But now whatever it is, they can't cross over the way that Marvel does.
Yeah,
Marvel's movies
are
just great.
What made Marvel appealing to a lot of people? I feel like first off, they nailed it with the first Iron Man movie.
Oh, yeah.
They nailed it.
Yeah.
Like. Yep. Everyone had given up on Robert Downey Jr. for the most part.
Mm-hmm.
This guy comes out of nowhere with a new character that most of us had never really tapped into because it was a comic book character. And then he made it funny, engaging, entertaining. He made you want to watch. And that's less than a 2-hour movie. And it literally rockets you to the top of the moon when it comes to the idea of, oh, this is where they're going. This is how they want to go forward. Okay, cool. I'm down for that. Mm-hmm. And then they surprised me. They surprised me with people like what's the one Paul Rudd plays? Ant-Man.
Yeah.
Ant-Man was a fantastic movie. Right, a character I had no clue about, didn't care about, didn't matter to me. Sat there with my wife one night, threw it on TV, and boom, it was amazing. Yeah. Like, it blew our minds. We were like, this is really good. Doctor Strange, the character. Mm-hmm. Don't care. Didn't like the new movie, by the way, the multiverse. Mm-hmm. Didn't like that one. But that. The first one was fantastic. And the Doctor Strange character, a little comedic relief there. The Hulk, a little comedic relief. The one thing Marvel did was they just took it and aside of T'Challa from Black Panther, and Tony Stark, when he's not trying to be like, you know, edgy or funny with his comments, beyond those two characters, everybody else has a bit of a comedic edge to them.
Sure. Yeah. Yep.
Even especially the Guardians. Even Captain America. Mm-hmm. Like, all the Guardians do. Like, well, by far, Batista.
Yeah,
and Guardians of the Galaxy, Drax the Destroyer.
Yeah,
it's fantastic,
isn't he?
It is. Yep,
he really is. He's a funny, entertaining, engaging guy. Groot, I could take or leave, but I don't hate Groot. I like Rocket Raccoon. Didn't even know he could be funny and entertaining. Right. Like, everybody has this funny, entertaining side to them. But Wonder Woman never came off as she was trying to ever be funny. It was always about the business.
For sure.
Batman was always about the business. It was never about trying to be funny or even charming when he was like dressed up as a rich guy at a party. It was always about, I'm just rich.
Yeah.
I'm going to go back to being Batman in a minute. Mm-hmm. Superman, Clark could be funny at times just because he's kind of goofy and gaffable, you know? But beyond that,
he's
like
quirky Superman, funny, though.
Yeah,
not
he's
like
quirky,
hilarious.
Sorry. Yeah, like he's not like Andy Samberg.
No,
funny,
he's not cracking
like,
jokes.
Cracking
he's
jokes. Just... But my point being, like, as Grant Superman, was, like, he was very astute.
Sure, yeah.
So when you enter this loudmouth young Flash character into the Justice League movie amongst these very astute individuals who always carry themselves with a certain grandeur, like, it was a mind blow. It was like, oh, this is funny. I'd like to see what goes. And it was like the only thing of the movie that I pulled from it and was like, this is pretty
Isn't that sad,
solid.
Though? Isn't that sad, though? That's the only thing you pulled from it?
I'm going to make 4 hours
Stop
of time.
Stop it, JSO, being all honest and truthful.
I'm going to make 4 hours of time, and I'm going to watch that Snyder Cut.
Don't do it.
Because I started
Don't
it.
Don't do it.
And I'm telling you, I'm almost embarrassed to admit. I didn't tell anybody because I was like, am I not understanding this?
Don't
am
do
I?
It.
Am I a moron? Because the beginning of that movie...
What is it again?
The Snyder Cut.
Yeah,
the Justice League. The beginning of that movie makes absolutely zero sense. It goes on forever.
Yeah.
It's like Superman screaming. And then, like, it's like... In fact, it looks terrible.
Yeah, CGI is terrible.
It looks like a YouTube video. Like... I thought my internet connection was bad.
This is how bad the Snyder Cut is to you?
Yeah, that's
CGI?
How it looks. Like, it looks
the
in the beginning.
But yeah,
like,
then they switch it and it's bad.
Yeah, it doesn't look like I thought my internet connection was bad. I thought something was going on because it was kind of like pixelated and fuzzy. It just didn't look right. And I had no idea what was going on.
It's true.
And then it starts and it's like, wait a minute, it's kind of like 20 minutes into the actual Justice League movie is where this one starts. It's like, I just turned it off. I was like, I have no idea what's going on. And I didn't admit to anybody that I saw it because I didn't want anybody to be like, what are you talking about? I didn't understand that. It's perfectly
At least you didn't pay to see it like some people.
Right? Yeah.
All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're almost up against the break here for this hour. But before we do that, coming up, we're going to have JSO hit the hot seat.
That's right.
That's right.
It's first time.
It's first time on the show, so he's got to hit the hot seat. But on top of that, AI, where are you guys at on artificial intelligence? How does it scream to you? Scary?
Terminator, right? Ultron,
you know,
I don't know.
What was it? Who was the company? Was it Google or Apple that had the chatbots or the two robots, and they had to pull the plug on it because the robots created their own language?
Sounds about right.
Started talking to each other.
No, I did not know that story.
We'll
but
look
now
that
I want
to look that up on the break.
Yeah, we'll look that up at the break, and we'll talk about that too. Because I got a story about AI.
Okay.
That is kind of interesting because it's kind of taken a weird turn.
Okay.
And I think both of you are going to be interested to find out the kind of weird turn that it took. And there's not much to this.
Robots?
There's really not much to the story other than what I tell you has happened. There really hasn't been any like interviews or anything in regards to it beyond like what everybody's kind of jumping on. But just the jumping off point for this. A little bit creepy, little bit interesting.
And I'm going to go out on a limb and say Donald Trump will not be involved in any sort of intelligence conversation, correct?
No, he will not.
He apparently can't have intelligence.
He'll steal it all.
He's not allowed to. All right, we're going to take a quick break here on the Q. We'll be back after this.
Q.
105.3 FM, 1280 AM, KYRO. This is The Q. I am Mark Blaine, your host, joined today by none other than my co-host, Jason Kull. You're over there, right? For sure? A little bit? You might be?
I most definitely am.
All right, as well as JSO.
Well, hello. I'm still here.
You are still here, even though we've bored you for hour plus now.
I've tried to leave five times, but he will not let me leave.
I keep throwing Jason in front of him because he's small and he won't stomp on his toes at all. I don't know why he
wore shoes. Yeah, you wore shoes.
Well, he did wear shoes.
Yeah. God, yeah.
All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to The Q. I am your host, Mark Bland, and we're sitting here talking to MMWA pro wrestler, who's got a match on September 10th down at South Broadway Athletic Club. Make sure you go check that out. JSO. And JSO, we were talking about artificial intelligence before we went to the break. And remember. I need
make
memory.
Me know stuff.
Make me know things. make words that go into the microphone thingy.
I don't know what you're
to
doing.
To do stuff right now.
Nope. This is not this. This is not artificial intelligence right here.
Don't we sound like a bunch of tech guys?
Yeah.
This is bad. Make me know stuff.
Help me say wordy things. That's what I need you to do right now. No. Let me know. What were your thoughts on AI once again?
The
break.
It's always bad, right? The Terminator.
It's always bad. It's the Terminator,
Ultron, all that stuff, right?
It never
always
turns
bad.
Out well.
Never does.
All right. Well, guys, this one didn't turn out well either, but we've got to talk about it for one quick second. Here's the deal. Jason Allen is a person from Colorado, and he took a piece of art to the digital category for the Colorado State Fair. Now, he took it and he entered it into the Colorado State Fair's digital art side of things and told them up front that he had used Midjourney, which is a artificial intelligence program of some sort that goes online. And there's a few out there. You can go Google this up, AIs. And they exist online where you can put in terms and stuff and they'll create things for you. He was able to create a digital artwork from using this program. Then he took the artwork and turned it into the Colorado State Fair.
So he cheated.
Digital category.
Okay.
Told them up front that it was made by an AI. Mm-hmm. And it still got first place. It still won first place. Told them that it was not created by his hand. He used AI, turned it in, and they still, themselves, knowing this information, still couldn't go down that row of individuals that turned in their digital artwork and give them the win over the artificial intelligence that created this piece of artwork. And that's scary to me, ladies and gentlemen, because along with the way that they're able like to digitally create, like they could take information of JSO or you, Jason, right now, input it into a computer and create a video that looks legitimately like you doing something that you're never doing in your life ever. Okay. And then putting that video out and going, oh, here's Jason right here. Jason Kull. He's busy, blah, 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 blah. And it's like, I've never done that in my entire life. No, here's the video right here. And anyone who looks at that video go, oh, that's you, Jay.
Yeah. Remember that, everyone.
Right, but I'm just saying.
Now like, I can do whatever I want.
But that's my point. Like, this exists already.
Yes.
Well, there's that one guy that does the deepfake Tom Cruise stuff.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
He looks just like him.
If we can deepfake to the point where your GTA is now coming off screen a little
bit. Sure, yeah.
Okay? And then on top of it, even when I tell you up front that it's deepfake or it's a problem, and you still give it the win, we are not dealing with a section of society or people. This Colorado, guys. Liberal Colorado, right? With all their weed smoking and all their liberalism.
I don't know, though. They got that Boebert idiot, too, though. And she's
they've got a section of that.
There's a section of them.
Is Boebert Colorado?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I thought Boebert was Alaska because she was buddies with Palin up there.
No, they're just faking that.
They just like each other.
All right. That makes sense.
So Colorado's.
I actually probably knew that she was from Colorado. I don't know why. Listen, can you help me say wordy things?
No, I still cannot.
This probably happened in her district.
This probably did.
No. She's an idiot.
But guys, this is crazy to me.
It is. What were the rules, though? What were the rules say they couldn't use it, though?
This one, he even put up a message after he won.
Okay.
Let me see if this, like, answers any questions
okay.
for me, because I don't know that answer. Hi, everyone. After a one-month hiatus, I have returned with an exciting announcement about my personal project I've been using called Midjourney. I have been exploring a special prompt that I will be publishing at a later date. I have created hundreds of images using it, and after many, many weeks of fine-tuning and curating my gems, I chose my top three and had them printed on a canvas after upscaling with Gigapixel AI. I entered it into the Colorado State Fair Fine Arts Competition, digital arts category, and I won first place. Here are the results. I've set out to make a statement using Midjourney in a competitive manner, and wow, I could not be more excited about having won. My favorite piece is called Theater d'Opera Special, that which is the piece that ended up winning the Colorado State Fair. So I don't know about how this comes about. I don't know, other than he decided to use this program, Midjourney, and turn this in. But I find it weird when you're told up front that it's AI or deepfake, and you still just are not willing to accept that. Now, that doesn't surprise us in this Trump country that we live in.
Yeah, they're not going to believe that.
Oh, well, what are we to believe?
They'll believe that, though.
What are we
they'll right? believe
that's
that.
The one they'll believe.
Here, let me read everybody something that's extremely hard to believe, okay? This one was truthed out, okay? Here you go. Terrible way the FBI during a raid of Mar-a-Lago threw documents haphazardly all over the floor, perhaps pretending it was me that did it, and then started taking pictures of them for the public to see. They thought they wanted to keep them secret. Luckily, I declassified.
Right.
Okay.
What a moron.
Saying I declassified, we've already talked about on the show a few weeks ago with Drew and a few other people, doesn't mean anything.
It's not even a thing.
No, okay. It's not. He's an idiot.
Listen, if this is how that works, JSO, congratulations. It's your first world championship for WWE. You're a world champion
now. That's top secret, actually.
Oh, it's top secret?
That's top secret. You guys didn't know that?
But you know what?
You can't declassify that.
What makes him even dumber than any. This statement is so dumb because they obviously did not throw them on the ground to show, like, he left them on the ground. They put that ruler to show size and scale.
Physical.
They did it for them.
Ladies and gentlemen, what people don't understand about any of this stuff going on with Donald Trump is an aspect of our society that you know the name of, but many people don't enter into that aspect of society, which is the courts and the legal system, okay? Yeah, you don't understand about getting a ticket and having to see the judge for the police and super stupid little things like that. But when you start getting into RICO cases, espionage trials for former politicians, things like this, there are procedures with the court that they have to follow.
Yep.
There is information that they have to dictate, which is size and scale of things.
Yeah.
There is video that, listen, ladies and gentlemen, I know you think this is all BS. Trust me, there is multiple videos of the raid, of them finding these documents in the door. Listen, and it's a non-cut video. Like, there is no cuts in this video. It's from before they even get out of the trucks
to
the minute they find the drawer and open it to the minute they get back in and leave. Like, there is no cuts to this video. You just haven't seen it because guess what? You're not a judge who's going to have to determine this stuff.
And it's Trump's own video. It's his security camera. So
some of it is, but I'm saying they have their own chess pieces that they wore and all that. Mm-hmm. Like, guys, this is not a... And by the way, I know that you're all out there saying, they're just taking this guy down. And you, in your mind, just a chump change little... Like I was talking about the fight at the bar.
Yeah.
In your mind, it's just an altercation that happened at the bar between the mayor and some councilman. That this is all going to get worked out over some Lining Kugel summer shandy. Plug right there. for the afternoon, and this is all going to get worked out. No, it's not. This is a former president of the United States. There are people putting their careers on the line, signing off on federal warrants and everything else. They know that if this goes sideways in the least bit at all, and they don't have one of their bases covered and lose everything, guess what? They're going to go away with no job and egg all over their face. And there's nothing that they're going to be able to do about it. And that's why this is so legit. Guys, the DOJ even accused Trump of moving the documents around the house and hiding them after they were previously searched for in the first place.
Yeah.
So they had already been there, had video of where they had found it in the first place.
Yes.
And when they found it the second time, it's in a completely different place. Like, you don't understand.
Yeah, that picture, that picture is from his office.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Three of those documents were found in his desk.
Like, why?
And as we talked about earlier on the show,
don't know.
These are documents that were so heavily secured that even the FBI, when it was time to investigate after the raid at Mar-a-Lago and they got this information, they had to go get special security clearance just to investigate the information that they found because it was of that level in nature that only a few people got. Guys, I don't want to beat a dead horse. I really don't. But I think that it's time for us to think about something, okay?
That Steve
I think it's time for us to all, and JSO, you'll probably agree with me. Let's all, it's time for us to look at it this way. Once again, perspective. Yes, let me give everybody a little perspective. We have a former president of the United States that took top secret classified nuclear, in some cases, documents with him. So sensitive that even the FBI had to get special clearance just to investigate them. He had them in his drawer at a golf course in Florida for the last year and a half.
Which previously, right before that, right, they hosted the Live Golf Tour, which is owned by and financed by the Saudi Arabia, right?
Sure.
So, and it was at Mar-a-Lago.
It was at Mar-a-Lago, weird.
With those documents there.
Wow.
The golf tournament, that was at Bedminster.
Oh, okay.
Oh, that was New Jersey.
Okay. But they did have something, right?
That Mar-a-Lago place, you have to pay, it's a $200,000 fee to be a member. Anybody can walk around that place. They found that that Chinese national.
Guys.
She had flash drives. She had some sort of sensor.
Anybody
that finds electronics?
Anybody think that MSB over there in Iran doesn't have a friend with a few bucks to where he can jump on a plane for about 16 hours, get
That's
to the United
point.
States, and then just go hang out with Donald Trump as just some regular guy, and then Donald Trump takes him into his office or this place or that place, closes the door, shows him the documents, lets them take pictures and stuff, throws it into his pocket, walks out, goes and plays a round of golf the next morning with Trump or somebody else, and then he jumps on the plane and goes back and just goes, here, MSB, terrorist that runs the world, here's all of the information you were looking for. Like, it's that simple. And yes, Trailer Park Boys, yes, it's that easy to do, just like in your trailer park.
Well, even if he didn't show it to anyone, some country just has to pay $200,000, put a couple of their guys as members, and go find it.
Now, somebody said to me, and I don't want to get into much of a discussion about this, but this could have been as bad as slavery was for the United States. This could be something at the same level when we all look back on it.
Yeah, the Trump years.
Okay, I don't think as far as slavery
but not
goes.
As no. bad.
Listen. No. Let me do this. Let me point of view again. Let's look at this as top three worst things that the United States has ever had to deal with in regards to the United States government. Yes. I would definitely put slavery in the top two.
Yes. Yes.
Because for sure, slavery was the reason for the Civil War. So the Civil War could be the top one. We did murder each other over this, okay? I feel like the finality of death and life, you know, I feel like that's a pretty high thing there.
Yes.
But, man.
Yeah.
Watergate might be number two. Or no, actually, probably Lincoln or John F. Kennedy getting assassinated is probably in the top three. But, I think that this is topping out on Watergate. Watergate, we discussed off the air, was a lot of Nixon giving things willingly over. Trump has stomped his foot the entire way and tried to do everything he can to stop it. So,
surprise.
I feel like once we're done, we're going to find out that you idiots in the trailer park. You idiots in the trailer park, people that JSO used to backyard wrestle with the trailer park.
I wouldn't do that with them. I wouldn't do that with them.
He didn't wrestle them. They just watched.
He didn't wrestle those people.
They watched.
They just came and watched. Fair enough.
But I made them pay.
There you go. My point being, you were so stupid to believe that a guy with big gold letters from a TV show was literally astute enough to be the president of the United States of America. He was smarter than the guy that sells you the can of Skull from behind the counter. Literally, you thought that? You're morons. And now we're finding out that this guy was a complete criminal. I think you're all criminals now. I really do. I don't trust conservatives when it comes to life anymore.
No, not at all.
There's no reason to. I'm not saying that every conservative is a bad person. I know lots of good people that are also vote conservatively. But like me and JSO and Jason have talked about offline, and we've even mentioned here live on the radio so far, there is the extreme people that are like Trump supporters and over their top, and they're just dumb as hell. It's always the big boobed blonde with the stupid cowboy hat made out of Coors can or Coors boxes talking about, I love Donald Trump, DJT forever. Like that girl, like moron, okay?
These are idiots.
Yes.
A lot of you are idiots, and I can't trust you anymore. And I don't want to trust you. Listen, you were talking about other wrestling organizations and people. There are people in professional wrestling. I've known them a long time. Don't trust them. Sorry. I'll go live on the air and say it. I don't trust them. And I've worked with MMWA. I've worked with Dynamo. I've worked with a lot of different organizations in this area. And I'm not saying those guys are because they're not on that list at all. But there are a few organizations and people that are on the list. I just don't trust you. And I know for a fact that they voted for Trump. I already know for a fact now without even talking to them over the last 15 to 20 years that they voted for Trump. So that's where we're at. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick break here on the Cube. When we come back, it's time for JSO to hit the hot seat. We'll be back on the Cube after this. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Cue. Myself, JSO from MMWA Wrestling, as well as Jason Kull, sitting here, hanging out here at the studios of News Radio KYRO.com. Now, you can listen to our show worldwide at NewsRadioKYRO.com every single week, Saturdays 1 to 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. And you can always go to theQNow.com, our website, and download the episodes after they debut. Share it with your friends. Tell your family members about it. We just want to entertain St. Louis and the world from the comfort of St. Louis. That's what we like to do. But JSO, you are here, sir, and it's time for you to do the hot seat.
I don't even know what that means, but okay.
You don't even know what that means.
It's amazing.
But okay. That's going to be your stance on this situation.
Sure, let's do this.
That's where you want to sit with this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, as long as that other guy just stays over where he's at and doesn't keep looking at me.
Okay.
Not even sure what his name is. I've been here for a while.
People who have not listened to The Cue or haven't checked out episodes of The Cue in the past, the hot seat is a simple situation where I ask this professional wrestler, in this case, five questions, right? These five questions, he has no clue what these questions are. He's not been talked to about this other than us telling him in the last segment, this is coming up. He had no idea these questions coming up. And this is just to get to know you a little bit better. This has really nothing to do with you personally or what you could be or not be here doing or why you're here. This is just for people to get to know you a little bit better, Jeff.
Great.
Instead of JSO, it becomes Jeff now.
No, Jeff. No, we're not
like
doing
Jeff
that.
Jeff the Killer.
No, we're not doing that.
You're not Jeff the Killer?
Nope. Mm-mm.
Okay, fair enough. All right, so here's what we're going to do. JSO.
Thank you.
Question number one. What is something that's common knowledge in life, right? But you found out just way too late. And it even kind of caught you off guard. And you're like, oh, I always thought it was this, but that's what that means? Oh, wow. I should have figured that one out way before this.
Oh, geez. Well, I was raised by my grandmother.
Okay.
Growing up. So very old school.
Meemaw? Grandma?
Grandma.
Just grandma?
Just grandma, yeah. Just
grandma. What? Grandma? Okay.
Shirley.
Grandma Shirley.
She was just grandma.
Grandma Shirley.
Yep. And so.
Sounds like a sweet lady.
She wasn't very sweet at all.
She wasn't sweet at all?
No, she was mean.
Oh. Okay.
She was nice to me, but she was very mean. Matter of fact, very direct. But I was not given a lot of the life lessons. Just general stuff, general knowledge.
Sure, of course.
Because I was protected. I was the ninth child she raised. She was, she was 56 when I was born. So she was much, much older. So she just really didn't prepare me for later teen years, into your early 20s,
okay.
That kind of stuff we kind of talked about earlier.
Sure, okay, yeah. The birds and the bees.
The real life. The real life stuff.
Yeah, things that could happen. Yeah. Drugs, alcohol, sex,
correct.
All of that. Yeah.
So I made a lot of mistakes just once, though. Only mistakes one time. I learned and didn't make them again. I just made all new ones.
Now, question.
Yeah.
Worst mistake you ever made was that alcohol, drugs, sex related? I mean, it's in the past. It's years ago.
No, honestly, the biggest mistake I made was, we talked about earlier, not going to West Point. Turning
okay.
that down.
You really think that West Point?
That was 2002, so it was right after 9/11.
Sure.
That whole thing kind of went down, and I was like, absolutely no military. Hell no.
Right. You're not looking to get kidnapped.
Yeah, I don't want to go there.
Terrorists
yeah.
or anything.
So I like hockey. I like ice and stuff, not deserts. But looking back now, of course, you know, being 38 and going, oh my gosh, biggest mistake I made.
Okay, that's fair. That's fair. I get that. Jason, anything that pops up in your mind from your past that you might think falls into this category? I got one.
Most mistakes are generally alcohol-related.
Okay, that's fair. Yeah. Mine was never make a decision when you're angry or horny. Or horny. Either one of those two things. Don't make a don't make decisions when you're angry or horny. Literally don't. Like, I know you want to make that phone call to so-and-so and have a conversation with them about this because you're really angry at the moment. Give yourself a step.
Text messaging.
Well, no, that makes it even twice as bad because there's no tone and inflection. But like, just take a step back, give yourself a few hours or a day, and then come back and reassess it at a later time. Because I've made a lot of decisions, but I learned that when I was probably almost close to 30. I learned that aspect of life just too late. And that's not something that you want to find out ill-advised on the backside of anything. All right, question number two, JSO. What actor will you always associate with that role, no matter how many other roles they do? Which actor, that role?
Well, again, we've kind of talked about this. Tony Stark, Robert Downey Jr.
Is it that role?
I mean, that role. I mean, honestly, the first original Avenger crew, right? Because it's such an epic moment for me and my, you know, and my fandom and all that, and just the concept of bringing a team together. Like that, every one of those characters, they cannot be replaced. It's almost can't be replaced.
That's like just that. who they are.
Yeah,
I would say for me, you know, and it's weird because most people when they think of Patrick Swayze, they go for a lot of other different movies. I still like Dirty Dancing. Big old school like one, and him in the black leather pants and jacket doing the dancing and all that. I just can never see that role with anybody else. Like that is a role that person always played. He was in Ghost, sure, didn't care. He was this guy over here. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. All right, question number three. Okay. Who would you put into the same category of evil as Hitler? Ooh. Same category of evil as Hitler, but you can't use Hitler. That's a tough one. That's a real tough one, man. I think Trump's getting there. I don't think it's evil necessarily. I think it's dumb foolery, trying to get away with dumb things. I don't feel that it's evil, but I feel like that the premise of what the documents and things could be used for is evil.
His selfishness.
Yeah, I think you're getting Putin's probably getting into that area too. I mean,
I guess, yeah.
Putin's starting to
get up there.
I just think it's probably something you don't know. It's probably someone in the shadow pulling the strings on these people that you don't even know a name of.
Like, is there anybody within your personal world in your life that you just hate so much? And you don't have to name their name, but is there somebody that might be in that same category?
No, not at all.
Now, I do have an ex. I will say about this ex, and I will not name her name, but I will say that at the time that the things went down the way they did, she definitely was on the same plateau as Hitler, in my mind.
You want to know a little fun fact?
Sure.
I do not have an ex, like a major ex who I dated for a long time, that's on Facebook.
Wait, say this again. You have no exes?
No ex.
He has never dated anyone before.
That you dated majorly. None of my pre-married girlfriends.
Right.
None of them are on Facebook.
Now, see, I found one of my deeper long-term girlfriends while I was dating my wife back in like 05, 06, 07. I found her on Facebook when it first started to get popular. Maybe 08.
I think so, yeah.
Around 08, 09, somewhere in there. I found her on Facebook. We chatted for like literally a couple of sentences. There wasn't much to talk about. You know, it wasn't a good breakup. Sure. It was probably necessary that we weren't together. And this isn't the one that's on the evil plateau either. But I found her. I talked to her for a couple of minutes. It's the only time I ever found a girlfriend or a past girlfriend on Facebook or talked to any of them.
There's exes. I mean, I have exes. I think there's one that recently, but it's just to the point now where why hold that grudge against, you know, that person did something to you, but I just can't hold a grudge anymore. It's just stupid.
Next question. Question number four. Your username is now your job in life.
Okay.
How's your life going? Tell us what's your username? It could be a video game handle or whatever. And then like, let's figure it out. How's life going?
Well, the two main ones I use is from a long time has been Shield Agent. So
Shield agent.
Yeah, so that would have been pretty good,
agent
right?
Yeah, you're good.
That's cool. There you go. Similar, right?
Agent Smith.
I could be Agent JSO, yeah.
Okay.
Or it was the God Butcher.
The God Butcher.
Yes.
That's even cooler.
Why the God Butcher?
So
explain
the
that
Thor
one.
Movie, the villain in the comic. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Again, it all it's comes back full circle on this.
Do you have any tats like superheroes?
No, I don't. Mm-mm.
Which is funny because you wrestled recently against a champion at MMWA called mm-hmm. Benjamin Trust.
Unfortunately, yes.
And Benjamin has them all over his torso.
And like, they're terrible. Like, they're look how what? Goofy looking
are you
they are.
Kidding me?
They're goofy looking.
That Hulk looks dope, bro.
Yeah, well, let's see if he actually made it anywhere outside of St. Louis. You think he can have the Hulk as a tattoo? No, he'd have to get that all covered up.
I don't Come understand on what you're trying to say here, JSO. It
just
sounds
like
to
Punk
me like you're
had finished. The Pepsi tattoo.
Did you wrestle him?
Huh? Yeah, I did.
And did you win?
I should have won. He cheated.
No. Did you
He cheated.
Win? Did you get your hand raised?
He cheated.
Cheetah's always
I don't want to talk about the past.
Okay,
I only
Mark.
Want to talk about the future.
Okay, Mark McGuire. It's cool.
Yeah. He didn't cheat
No
either.
Big deal.
It was
no
legal at the
deal.
Time.
Question number 5. Let me see here. Let me pick a really good one out for you because, okay, I think that this actually is a pretty good question for the 5 hot seat questions. To be number 5, what would make your life better right now? Like, if there was one thing you could point to, and I know everybody could be like, I wish I had a significant other, cool. I wish I had a lot of money, cool. Like, what would make your life better right now? If you were to think about it for a second, like, what you're like, if I could have this, or if mm-hmm. I could be here, like, what would make your life better?
I would have to say, so I got injured about, 6 weeks ago now in a wrestling match? And so I tore my labrum, my left
Ooh,
shoulder.
Now, where's that? Is on the front or the backside?
It's in the back. This mine's, in the, back mine's in the back area.
Okay, mm-hmm. Your labrum's in the back.
So so I tore it, and it's been slowly healing. So if that could just go away, that'd be great, because then I can really get back to lifting weights, heavy weights, and really take the ring action to a next level.
All right, fair enough. Mm-hmm. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's going to do it for our boy JSO on the hot seat. Here on The Q, Jason, those are all great questions that he was asked, and these are all great answers that he gave. I have to admit, like, we're now here at the end of the show, okay? I have had two hours to sit here and hang out with JSO on a one-on-one basis, get to know him a little bit better, get into that psyche over there, that avatar that is the excellence that he calls himself, you know?
Yes, very much so.
So I got a chance to really peek inside, and he's a little arrogant.
Whoa, hold on a second here.
But it works.
He's a little cocky. He's a little cocky and arrogant.
I want him to win now.
You do?
I do. I want him to win.
He was mad you were wearing shoes so he could stomp on your feet, called you a midget.
But
like, I don't even know what's going on here.
But I was able to overcome that.
I got a new thing on the show. So now, JSO.
Yes.
You've been on the queue.
I have.
You've hung out with Mark Bland. You've hung out with Jason Kull over here.
Okay.
What's your impression? I'd like to get your thoughts. I want to get the feedback from the people out there, the ones on the streets, in the ring, handling the business.
Well, first of all, you're welcome.
Okay.
For me showing up tonight. So
thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Second of all, don't you assist that one dummy that is down at MMWA? He's supposed to be some sort of commissioner. What's his name?
Okay, so you're talking about the fact that I was recently asked by the Shaft, a former wrestler that I worked with at Broadway many, many, many years ago. He came to me and asked me if I could kind of come around, hang out, check out the situation, maybe see if I could help out around the place. And I said, yeah, sure. I don't have a problem doing that. So I came down to that last match.
Okay.
I told you, and you know, we hung out and it was fine. It was cool. It was like, I don't really have any job though. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm the assistant commissioner, which is a job.
Sure.
But like, they haven't given me anything to physically do yet. So I don't have anything. Like, I don't have a dog in this fight. Maybe that's the way to put it.
Well, Mark, then I'm going to need you to get a dog in the fight and start,
is there
throwing a little something for JSO down there and stop messing around here.
That's what I was going to ask. Is there a dog that you want me to back?
Would be me.
Oh, you want me to get behind you?
Yeah, duh. What?
come on now.
Well, don't you think everybody wants me to get behind them? Like, don't you think I would hope everybody wants that sounds me a little to sexual, help them out?
That sounds a little sexual. It I don't know about
I think
sexual.
Everyone wants you to be.
Listen, my wife doesn't even want me to get behind her.
Well,
I'm
sorry.
Okay?
I'm sorry.
Right? So I don't know. You're going with this. No. By the way, are you married?
I am, yes. I am
How
married.
How long have you been married?
Oh, gosh. Officially married a year now.
Oh, hey.
One over a year. All right. Yes.
And she,
together, seven.
Does she love pro wrestling?
No, she hates it.
That's what my wife
she
was.
Absolutely
she
hates
absolutely
it.
Hated pro wrestling. My yes. wife didn't want that to see true. Nothing. She doesn't care.
Now, I do have three daughters.
You have three kids. Three daughters.
17, 14, and 12.
So you're the dad of like a senior in high school.
Yeah, now you know why I'm, you know, I do right. it.
Now, question. Yes. Grandma yeah. Shirley, she didn't show you all the birds and the bees or talk about that stuff between that ages of 15 mm-hmm. and 25 or whatever, that range there.
Yes.
She got a daughter, 17, do you?
Yes.
Do you guys have those conversations?
Yes.
Does she come to her dad? Do you guys have a close relationship?
Very open relationship, yes. Very good relationship. With
yeah,
her.
Me and my daughter have a pretty open relationship, right, yeah. but it's by her end. It's on her hand.
Yep.
All right.
And the 17-year-old
yes.
went down for the first time to the gym, the local gym here, to learn how to take bumps to wrestle.
All right.
What gym?
So Team Ambition.
Team Ambition.
Yes.
Are you a part of Team Ambition?
I am a part of Team Ambition, yes.
All right. Well, that is an interesting piece that shows up completely at the end of this conversation. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for us to get out of here on the queue. I'm going to talk to you a little bit about that off
you
the
should.
Air.
You're great, Mark. I love you.
Okay. wow. Did you notice how quickly that changed when that piece of information just came out?
You're an idiot, Mark.
Okay. Thank you.
We're back.
All right. Yeah, we're back to normal now. All right. So first off,
I got
thank
confused.
You, Jeff O'Connor, JSO, the Avatar of Excellence, the Savior of South Broadway. We thank you. First off, number one, thank you for being a guest here on the queue. We
You're
really
welcome.
Do appreciate it. And we look forward to seeing you on September 10th, MMWA Wrestling down at South Broadway Athletic Club. Make sure you guys get on Google, check that out. Just search up MMWA Wrestling tickets. And it'll pop up right there for you to get tickets to come down. See JSO. See the ladies get their title for the first time in many, many years. Find out who the winner of that is going to be. And I also want to thank Jason Kull.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jason, for being here. Make sure you guys check out theqnow.com, theqnow.com. Old episodes, new episodes, and everything in between. That's going to do it for me and you here on 1280 AM, 105.3 FM, KYRO. We will see you guys next week on this show.